Want to speak real French from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at FrenchPod101.com.
Hey, watchers! This week we're going to learn about top 25 French phrases. Let's go! Bonjour! Bonjour is hello. Bonjour, bonjour, bonjour. Hey! Okay, now you can say bonjour any time of the day, even if it's night. Salut, hi. Hi is salut. Salut, comment ça va? Hey, how you doing? So, salut is like bonjour, and you can also use it to say hi and to say goodbye. So when you leave, you can also say salut, à la prochaine. Ça va, how are you? You can say ça va, like just after salut, ça va. Or bonjour, ça va. Or comment ça va? If you only say ça va, it's kind of missing something, so put it after a greeting. So, how are you? How you doing? Comment ça va? Bonsoir. Good evening. Not good night. Almost good night, but not. Bonsoir is also a greeting you can use when you leave or when you enter someone's place. For example, if you go in the evening to someone's house or party, you can say, ah, bonsoir tout le monde. Bonne nuit. Good night. Good night is bonne nuit, person sleeping next to you. Bonne nuit. Or to your family when you go to sleep. Oui. Yes. Yeah. Oui. You also say yeah. Maybe you've heard oui, oui. Like French people often do this. Oui, oui. It's also a cartoon for children. Oui, oui and his little car. You should try and watch it in French. It's very educative. Non. Non, non. You have oui, oui and non, non. We often say them both. Just use yes and no. Oui et non. Je m'appelle. My name is. Je m'appelle Lia. You knew that already, huh? What's your name? Leave it in the comment in French. S'il vous plaît. Please.
Please. S'il vous plaît.
This is a polite version. And if you want the more friendly version, is s'il te plaît. If you're asking a friend.
S'il te plaît. Give me your candy. I'm starving. S'il te plaît. Donne-moi des bonbons.
L'addition, s'il vous plaît. D'accord. OK. So, we also use OK, but with a French accent. OK. Hi, how you doing? When you come to the cinema with me?
D'accord.
Excusez-moi. Excuse me. If someone is blocking the way, you just say, excusez-moi. Merci. Thank you. Please learn this one and be polite. In French, we just have merci. There is no short version of it, and you can use it for anyone. So, when you receive something at the grocery store, ah, merci. Or when someone does you a favor, ah, merci. If you want to be really polite or really thankful, you can say merci beaucoup. Thanks a lot. De rien. So you are welcome. If someone says merci to you, you can just say ah, de rien. So merci et de rien. Those come in a pair, so learn them together. It's nice. Il est quelle heure? What time is it? Or quelle heure il est? You will more often hear the second version. So oh, excusez-moi, quelle heure il est? Excuse me, what time is it? Où sont les toilettes? Where is the bathroom? We don't have many available bathrooms in public places and usually they are really dirty. So, or maybe if you are at someone's house, you can ask, où sont les toilettes? Enchanté, nice to meet you. Bonjour, enchanté, je m'appelle Lia. And here you have three of today's words together. Isn't it nice? Bonjour, je m'appelle Lia, enchanté. Comment ça va? Hi, nice to meet you. My name is Lia. How you doing? And you have all of them to greet people and start a nice conversation. So nice to meet you. Enchanté. À bientôt. See you soon. This is what I should say at the end of each video. See you soon or à bientôt. Use it when you leave. That's about it. À demain. See you tomorrow. See you tomorrow. À demain. Yeah. Au revoir. Bye bye or goodbye. Au revoir is kind of polite. You can use it with everyone as well. So if you want to be more friendly, we use like ciao. Au revoir is only for leaving. So yeah, goodbye.
Goodbye, watchers. See you next time. À bientôt.
No,
not yet, because I'm going to see you guys a lot.
Bien sûr. Of course. Bien sûr que c'est le cas. If you want to be sarcastic, you can say oui, bien sûr. We mostly use it this way. Because we like being sarcastic. So yeah, of course. Yes, yes, you are. Yes. Je peux utiliser. May I use?
Something, something.
So fill the blank with whatever you want. Can I use your pencil? Je peux utiliser ce stylo. Je suis désolé. I'm sorry. Yeah, if you bump into someone, you can also use this one. Like, oh, je suis désolé. If I bump into somebody, they won't wake up, duh.
Moon, don't go where he pleases! Yeah! Terminator is more like this.
I'm sorry, je suis désolé. Pourquoi? Why?
Why? Pourquoi?
C'est vrai? Really?
C'est vrai? C'est vrai?
Oh, fine. So, if you are hearing gossip and stuff, you're gonna be like, oh, c'est vrai? No, c'est vrai? Oh, c'est vrai?
Really?
Yeah. And you can use it with all the intonations. C'est vrai?
C'est vrai.
So the opposite of c'est vrai is c'est pas vrai. No, it's not. Or not really. Je ne comprends pas. I don't understand.
Leah never understand. Leah say her name a lot. Or else she forgets. Happened before.
When someone is speaking too fast, like I do, I'm sorry, je suis désolé. You can tell them je ne comprends pas. Or... Yeah, because they have all those fancy French words and vocabulary. You can be like, non, je ne comprends pas. At the end! So, remember those main sentences and don't forget to subscribe and leave me a comment if you ne comprends pas. Bye bye! Au revoir et à bientôt! Please stop it, I'm waving.
Hi everyone, I am Lindsay from FrenchPod101.com. In this video, we'll be talking about the top 10 must-know phrases for the restaurant. Let's begin. Oh my gosh, again food, I'm so hungry. Une table pour trois, s'il vous plaît. Une table pour trois, s'il vous plaît. A table for three, please. Actually, I used that a lot when I was in Italy. But it was a table pour trois, per favore. A table pour trois, per favore. Anyways, you can use this phrase when making a reservation. You can change the number depending on how many people are with you. For example, to reserve a table for two, you can say une table pour deux, s'il vous plaît. Une table pour deux, s'il vous plaît. Pour une table pour un, for a table just for one, you will say une table pour un. Le menu, s'il vous plaît. Le menu, s'il vous plaît. The menu, please. Use this when you can see the menu on the table or the waiter forgot to bring one. This happens a lot. J'aimerais ceci, s'il vous plaît. J'aimerais ceci, s'il vous plaît. I'd like this dish, please. You can say this while indicating on the menu. It may come in handy if you're not sure how to pronounce a dish name. Yeah, I use that a lot myself, especially for Japanese food. Sans oignons, s'il vous plaît. Sans oignons, s'il vous plaît. Without onions, please. If you don't like something, you should memorize this. You can refer to anything else by substituting oignon with a different noun. For example, if you want to order a beverage without ice, you can say sans glaçons, s'il vous plaît. Sans glaçons, s'il vous plaît. Sans tomates, without tomatoes. Sans tomates. Pourriez-vous m'apporter du sel? Pourriez-vous m'apporter du sel? Can you please bring me the salt? Yeah, American people love salt. I don't know why, because I don't. You can use this phrase to ask for seasonings such as salt or pepper or a missing tableware. Excusez-moi. Excusez-moi. Excuse me. Use this to call the waiter's attention. Excusez-moi! While trying to make eye contact. Sometimes they might ignore you, unfortunately. Où sont les toilettes? Où sont les toilettes? Where is the bathroom? This may turn useful in any situation, not only when you are at a restaurant. For example, if you are in the street and ask, où puis-je utiliser les toilettes? Where can I use restrooms or bathroom? Qu'est-ce que ce plat contient? Qu'est-ce que ce plat contient? What does this dish have in it? If you have allergies, you have to learn this question to make sure you can fully enjoy your meal. Yes, sometimes at restaurants they ask you if you have any allergies, but sometimes they don't, so please make sure to ask. Est-ce que c'est possible de payer séparément? Est-ce que c'est possible de payer séparément? Is it possible to pay separately? You can ask this question when paying the bill and if you want to split the amount. For example, when you go out with your friends, you can ask for a separate bill, right? Donc, l'addition séparée? L'addition, s'il vous plaît. L'addition, s'il vous plaît. The bill, please. When you are ready to leave the restaurant, use this phrase to ask for the bill. It's common to pay at the table, and though you are not expected to give it a tip, it is always a kind gesture to leave some loose change. Yeah, in America, you are expected to do so. In France, not really. But you can give like 1 or 2 euros, you know? Okay, so that's all for this lesson. Which phrase do you like more? Leave a comment letting us know. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and go to FrenchPod101.com for more resources. We'll see you next time. À bientôt!
Hi, watchers! Are you coming to France soon? Because this week we are going to learn about 20 travel phrases you should know. Merci, thank you. Anytime you receive something or someone was nice to you, merci, thank you. Excusez-moi, excuse me. Anytime you bump into someone, or if you step on the foot because the metro is crowded, or if you need to call for the waiter's attention, use this one. Excusez-moi. Combien ça coûte? How much is this? Yeah, sometimes you won't find the prices on the items you are looking for, especially if you're going to a flea market in France. So just go, ah, this item, how much is it? Cet objet, combien ça coûte? Où est la gare? Where is the train station? This one can be quite convenient. If you are in a big city, where is the metro? Où est le métro? Le Wi-Fi est-il gratuit? Is the Wi-Fi free? If you want Wi-Fi in France, maybe some coffee shops now have it. They advertise it on the chalkboard outside. So come inside, we have Wi-Fi. Je voudrais ceci. I'd like this. Oh, I'd like this, please. Je voudrais ceci, s'il vous plaît. If you don't know the name of the item you want in the menu, you can just point and say, je voudrais ceci. I want this, please. Pourrions-nous avoir le menu, s'il vous plaît? Could we have the menu, please? Usually you have to ask for it. Sometimes the place is very crowded, so ask. Le menu, s'il vous plaît. Could we have the menu, please? Avez-vous des recommandations? Do you have any recommendations? If you are at a bar and want for some cocktail, it can be like, oh, I like something fruity. Do you have any recommendation? J'aimerais quelque chose de fruité. Avez-vous des recommandations? And then the bartender will make you some fancy cocktail. Je suis allergique aux cacahuètes. I'm allergic to peanuts. If you have any allergies, be sure to ask whenever you are going out or trying to eat something. People will be really nice about it, and sometimes it's even on the menu. If you have any allergies, there will be a sign saying, yes, this contains nut, or this contains milk, or this contains gluten, and you can make sure that you don't eat something you don't want to ingest. Avez-vous des plats végétariens? Do you have any vegetarian dishes? If you are vegetarian or vegan, there will also be a sign very often on the menu saying this dish contains no meat, or this is vegan safe, it's made with no animal grease or eggs or milk. Pourrais-je avoir l'addition? Could I have the check? Pourrais-je avoir l'addition, s'il vous plaît? Could I have the check, please? Prenez-vous la carte de crédit? Do you take credit card? Can I pay by credit card? Puis-je payer avec ma carte de crédit? Tiens! Pourriez-vous me prendre en photo, s'il vous plaît? Could you take a picture of me, please? What, you don't have your selfie stick? Come on, that's something every traveler should have. 1, 2, 3, whistiti! Je voudrais un siège non-fumeur, s'il vous plaît. I'd like to have a non-smoking seat, please. Well, restaurants in France have banned smoking inside for a couple of years now. So every restaurant you go to should be non-smoking. Smoking is only allowed in bars. Good luck with that. Do you have non-smoking seats? Avez-vous des sièges non-fumeurs? Pourriez-vous me donner un rabais? Could you give me a discount? Un peu moins cher? A little bit cheaper? This is again if you go to flea market, and especially on Sundays, you will have a bunch of sellers selling stuff from their homes. You can negotiate the price a lot over there. And getting an item half price is really common. So you can say, un peu moins cher. Ou, est-ce que je pourrais avoir un rabais? S'il vous plaît, give me a discount, please. Or make it cheaper, a tiny bit cheaper. Okay, more cheap, even cheaper, way cheaper. Okay, give it to me, free, now. Pourrais-je obtenir un plan? Could I get a map? Plan would be more a map of something you want inside, for example, if you're in a museum. And if you are outside and got lost and go to the information center, for example, you can ask, pourrais-je avoir une carte? Could I get a map? J'ai une réservation. I have a reservation. When you get to a restaurant and have a reservation, they will often ask you at the front desk, so do you have a reservation? Avez-vous une réservation? You can say, yes, I have a reservation. Oui, j'ai une réservation. Puis-je essayer? Can I try this on? Yeah, if you want to try some clothes, you can ask the staff. Puis-je essayer ceci? Can I try this? Parlez-vous anglais? Do you speak English? French people aren't really good at speaking English, but they will try their best. So if you find someone and cannot express yourself in French properly, and ask them, parlez-vous anglais? Do you speak English? They may say, no, not that much, but no, je ne parle pas beaucoup, ou je ne parle pas anglais. The most common sentence I learn in every language is a beer, please. Une bière, s'il vous plaît. Anytime it's summer, it's hot, and you want something fresh, une bière, s'il vous plaît. A beer, please. To go with your nice meal, or just to freshen up and chill with friends. So that's it for this week. What's your most used travel sentence? Leave me a comment to let me know. And if you want to learn more French, don't forget to check the website. FrenchPod101.com. We'll see you next time. See ya.
Want to speak real French from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at FrenchPod101.com.
Hi, everyone. I am Lindsay from FrenchPod101.com. And in this video, we'll be talking about 10 phrases to help you in an emergency. Let's begin. Appelez la police, s'il vous plaît. Call the police, please. Use this phrase when you need someone to call the police. In France, you call 17. They should be called if there is a need of police intervention. For example, an accident on a public highway, public disorder, aggression, a robbery, a burglary, etc. Avez-vous de la fièvre? Do you have a fever? Use this phrase when you want to check someone's temperature. Generally, when seeing this sentence, you place your hand on the person's forehead to feel if it's warm. J'ai perdu mon passeport. I lost my passport. Use this phrase when, unfortunately for yourself, you lose your passport. In this situation, find and contact the nearest embassy or consulate from your country. Ouf. Je pense que j'ai mangé quelque chose de mauvais. I think I ate something bad. Use this phrase when you are not feeling very well due to intestinal discomfort and you want something to help the pain. J'ai besoin d'un médecin. I need a doctor. Use this phrase when you are not feeling very well. If you are sick, you must see a doctor. Je ne retrouve pas le chemin jusqu'à mon hôtel. I can't find the way back to my hotel. Use this phrase when you are lost and can't go back to your hotel. In this situation, you can try to find a reputable store. Explain your situation to one of the employees and they will maybe help you. An offline map app is also useful. Y a-t-il une pharmacie dans le coin? Is there a pharmacy nearby? Use this phrase when you need to find a pharmacy without going too far. Do not hesitate to ask a shopkeeper around you. They might know better than the average person on the street. Pourriez-vous m'aider? Can you help me? Use this phrase when you need assistance and you want to ask someone. You can add excusez-moi, excuse me, at the beginning of the sentence to be more polite. Je suis perdu. I am lost. Use this phrase when you are lost. As I already said, do not hesitate to ask to someone like a storekeeper or a police officer to help you. J'ai besoin d'une ambulance. I need an ambulance. Use this phrase when you need an ambulance to come. Usually you can call 112, the European emergency number, even if you don't speak French. Okay, that's all for the 10 phrases to help you in an emergency. And if you really want to become fluent and speak French from the very first lesson, go to FrenchPod101.com. Please leave a comment below and don't forget to subscribe. I will see you next time. À bientôt.
Hi everyone. Are you ready to eat some French food? Here are 10 must-know vocabulary for the restaurant. Let's go. Serveur. Waiter. Serveur. Waiter. Frédéric est serveur. Frédéric is a waiter because he has to pay for, I don't know, university, so in the summer you can be a waiter. Serveuse, waitress. Serveuse, waitress. La serveuse tient un plateau avec des verres. The waitress is holding a tray with glasses.
Sure.
I couldn't be a waitress because I would just break everything because I'm clumsy. I admire people who can wait properly. Menu, menu. Menu, menu. Ce menu est à prix fixe. This menu is at a fixed price. Yeah, when you go to a restaurant, you will usually have a la carte menu where you can choose the items you want, and then a fixed price menu when you can choose between two or three different items, and if you want appetizers and a main and one more thing, and if you want dessert or cheese. And depending on that, the price can vary. Commander, to order. Commander. To order. J'ai commandé le plat du jour. I ordered the dish of the day.
Good job.
Eau. Water. Eau. Water. Tu devrais boire plus d'eau. You should drink more water. And I should also drink more water.
It gets your skin nice and fresh.
Dessert. 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 Dessert is my favorite thing. La tarte tatin est un dessert populaire qui peut être commandé dans la plupart des brasseries françaises. Mm-hmm. Tarte tatin is a common dessert that can be ordered in most French brasseries, which are traditional tiny restaurants. It's a nice dessert with apple, and the secret is to bake it reversed, so with the apple at the bottom and the dough on top.
So they say.
I think it was discovered when someone dropped the tart the other way or put it the wrong way in the oven and then discovered that it was a tasty way to bake. Because the dough will keep the warmth inside and the apple will bake in their own juice and being a bit steamed too because the dough is on top. And when you flip it back, then the dough stay drier, let's say, because it doesn't soak up all the juices from down
the apple.
Yeah, from all the apples. So then you flip it back, and it's nice. The apple gets really tight and compact and really molten. Yum, 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 yum. Restauration rapide. Fast food. Restauration rapide. Fast food. Les hamburgers et les frites sont considérés comme étant de la restauration rapide. Burgers and fries are considered fast food. Yum, 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 yum. I like hamburgers. With bacon. What are we talking about? Probably food again. Restaurant. 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 Le restaurant est très bon. The restaurant is really good. Of course it is. It's French. If you can save a bit when you go to France and go to a really good restaurant, you should try it because it's worth it. So try it at least once. Note. Bill. Note. Bill. Serveur, la note. Waiter, the bill. Try to be a bit more polite and say at least, please. Like, can I have the bill, please? And don't call the waiter, waiter. Just say, can I have the bill, please? Puis-je avoir la note, s'il vous plaît? Would be a more polite way to say so. Délicieux. Delicious. Délicieux. Delicious. Mm. C'est plus que bon, c'est délicieux. This is more than good. This is delicious. I like delicious crepe. And you can make a ton of crepe and then you can eat all the crepe. With as many toppings as you want. Mm. My favorite is chocolate and banana and whipped cream. If you want more food and restaurant vocabulary, we have more on the website. Or subscribe, because we also have more on YouTube. And we will see you next time. Yeah. Nom, 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 nom. Hee-haw. Hee-haw.
Hee-haw.
Too much sugar. Bah. So are you ready to travel to France? If so, don't forget to prepare well. I'm Leah, and this is Top 10 Ways to Prepare for Your Travel. Let's go. Choisir sa destination. To choose one's destination. Je dois choisir ma destination ce mois-ci. I have to choose my destination this month. What would be your favorite destination?
Well, it would be France, obviously. But if you have another one, let me know in the comments. I always choose Japan. Or Singapore. Singapore is great. Acheter un guide touristique. To buy a guidebook. My favorite is Lonely Planet or the Michelin Guide. Mon ami achète toujours des guides touristiques. My friend always buys guidebooks. I usually buy some too, or check out on the internet, because I want the cheap deal and the good food inside. Sometimes we even get discount from the guidebook. And you also get some survival phrases. So try it. Économiser de l'argent. To save money. Il économise de l'argent depuis 5 ans. He has been saving money for 5 years. What kind of travel is he planning to do? Well, the more you save, the more you can spend on your travel. So if you really want to go all out and see all the things and eat all the stuff, just save for a while and then you can enjoy it a lot. Rechercher les prix. To research the costs. Je n'ai pas encore recherché les prix. I haven't researched the costs yet. You should research the costs first. And then start saving because you know how much you need then. Réserver un vol. To book a flight. Quand réserverons-nous notre vol? When will we book our flight? As soon as possible. Seriously, because it's cheaper. Ideally 6 months in advance. And I have a point card for every airline I ever went on. This way I can accumulate it with, I don't know, everything, just in case. Just get the card because it's free and maybe they treat you better and you have higher chances of being upgraded. Or so I heard. Demander des congés. Request vacation time. Il demande toujours des congés au dernier moment. He always requests vacation time at the last moment. Don't forget to do this way in advance because your colleagues need to adjust for your time out. I requested mine way in advance and, you know, people still ask me for stuff when I'm on holiday.
Leah, this Sunday needs to be done.
Réserver un hébergement. To book accommodation. Ils passent toujours par un site internet pour réserver un hébergement. They always book accommodation through a website. Because it's pretty convenient and if you don't know the language, it can be quite tricky to reserve your accommodation at the accommodation place. But it's easier to compare prices. Don't forget to book also way in advance when it's appropriate season to go. Or else you end up in a way too expensive place or under a bridge. And we don't like being under a bridge. Renouveler son passeport. To renew one's passport. Je dois bientôt renouveler mon passeport. I need to renew my passport soon. Don't forget to also do this way in advance because it can take 1 or 2 months to get all your paperwork done and you don't want to miss your trip just because your passport is expired. That would be sad. Faire ses valises. To pack. Vous n'avez pas encore fait vos valises? You haven't packed yet? I always pack at the last minute because that's one of my superpowers. If you are not good at packing, watch a few packing tip videos online. It's really useful and then you can bring only one suitcase instead of three. Obtenir un visa. To get a visa. J'ai obtenu un visa de 5 ans. I got a 5-year visa. Be sure to also check the country you are going to see if you need a visa because you don't want to get there and be rejected because you forgot to fill some paper. And if you don't need a visa, be sure to check the number of days you are allowed to stay without a visa. So what's the one place you want to travel to or what are your best travel tips for preparation? Leave it to me in the comments and for more travel words, check the website to learn more things. Or subscribe because we also have more travel videos. And we will see you next time. Have a safe flight.
Want to speak real French from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at FrenchPod101.com.
Hi everyone, I am Lindsay from FrenchPod101.com. In this video, we'll be talking about the top 15 must-know phrases to go shopping. Let's begin. C'est combien? C'est combien? How much is it? You can simply point at something and say c'est combien. C'est combien? Yeah, I ask that a lot. Vous l'avez dans une autre couleur? Vous l'avez dans une autre couleur? Do you have it in another color? You can ask this when shopping for anything that is available in different colors. Vous l'avez en taille M? Vous l'avez en taille M? Do you have it in medium? This is a useful phrase when shopping for clothes or anything that has sizes. Because I wear S or XS, I will say vous l'avez en S ou XS. J'en veux deux. J'en veux deux. I want two of these. It is pretty simple. You just want to say j'en veux plus the amount you desire. For example, if you want three, you just say j'en veux trois. Je peux le voir? Je peux le voir. May I see it? You can also explicitly mention what you want to see. For example, je peux voir le menu? Je peux voir le menu, which means may I see the menu? Or, je peux voir ce crayon? May I see this pen? Je peux l'essayer? Je peux l'essayer? Can I try it on? This may come in handy in a clothing shop. Yeah, I usually ask to the cashier if I can try tops or dresses. J'aime bien celui-là. J'aime bien celui-là. I like that one. Use this when you make up your mind for something and you want to buy it. For example, you can say, j'aime bien ce jean. I really like these jeans. Je n'aime pas cette couleur. Je n'aime pas cette couleur. I don't like this color. This sentence works as a good excuse when you don't want to buy something. I actually use it a lot. If you want to be more general and say something like, I don't like this, you can simply say, je n'aime pas cela. Je n'aime pas cela. For example, je n'aime pas ce top que vous me présentez. I don't like this top that you are showing me. Je cherche. Je cherche. I am looking for. Use this when you need help from a shop assistant. For example, you can say, je cherche un cadeau d'anniversaire. Je cherche un cadeau d'anniversaire, which means I am looking for a birthday present. Usually, from what I see in America, shopping assistants come to you directly and say, hey, do you need help finding anything? Sometimes a bit annoying. Est-ce qu'il y a un miroir? Est-ce qu'il y a un miroir? Is there a mirror? This is another way to explain what you are looking for. You can substitute miroir with another noun. For example, est-ce qu'il y a des toilettes? Are there any restrooms? Vous acceptez la carte de crédit? Vous acceptez la carte de crédit. This means, do you take credit cards? Yeah, some places they just take cash. If you don't have any cash, be sure to ask this question before purchasing any service or product. Yeah, a lot of people walk with their credit card in hands, not with cash, so be sure to ask. C'est trop serré. C'est trop serré. It's too tight. You can use another word instead of serré. For example, c'est trop cher. C'est trop cher. It's too expensive. I use this sentence a lot. So hey, if you want to buy me something, I take it. Où sont les cabines d'essayage? Où sont les cabines d'essayage? Where are the dressing rooms? This is useful in a clothing shop, but you may use it in a different situation by changing the last word. For example, où sont les toilettes? Où sont les toilettes, which means where is the bathroom? Je l'utilise beaucoup. I use it a lot. Vous fermez à quelle heure? Vous fermez à quelle heure? What time do you close? It's important to check opening hours or heures d'ouverture. Usually in France, shops are open Monday to Saturday from 9 in the morning until 8 in the evening. But in small towns, some shops may be closed during lunchtime. Et ça peut être fermé également très tôt. It can be closed very early as well. Je voudrais retourner. Je voudrais retourner. I would like to return. This is a key phrase when you want to return something you bought. Be sure to check the return policies. For example, many shops require the receipt. Je le fais souvent quand je veux retourner des vêtements. I do it a lot when I want to return clothes. Okay, so that's all for this lesson. Which idea do you like the most? Leave a comment letting us know. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and go to FrenchPod101.com for more resources. We'll see you next time. À bientôt!
Hi everyone! If you are coming to France, you will probably need to take the train or the metro, and probably even in Paris. So let's have 10 phrases to survive at the station, because it's pretty hard in there. It's the jungle! J'aimerais aller à... I'd like to go to... J'aimerais aller à... I would like to go to... Then put the name of the place. Whether it's a city, if you're taking the train, or if it's a metro, you might want to know more precise location. So, if you can find someone at the ticket counter, just ask. J'aimerais aller à... And then they will give you the directions. Est-ce la bonne plateforme pour... Is it the right platform for... Est-ce la bonne plateforme pour... Is it the right platform for... Place. So if the station is really big, you will have a lot of platforms. And sometimes it might get confusing, so you might want to ask if you're on the right place. And if it's a metro, for example, or a tramway, they go both directions, so you want to be sure you are on the right side of the platform to get the right direction, or else you would go the other way, and it can get tricky. À quelle heure est le dernier train? What time is the last train? À quelle heure est le dernier train? What time is the last train? This question sounds so Japanese. If it's a big normal train, they may have trains all day and sometimes even night trains. And if you are talking about a metro or tramway train, then depending on the cities, sometimes they finish later. But around midnight is a good safe spot for the last train, so try to get them before midnight. Sometimes they have some after, but that's mostly in bigger cities, so you don't want to take that risk. Où puis-je changer pour? Where do I change for? Où puis-je changer pour? Where can I change for? Place. I didn't change at the proper spot and ended up 250 kilometers away from where I was supposed to be. Ah, whoopsie. Be sure to check that. And be sure also to have enough time before trains to change. If you're going from a big train to a big train and going through a big train station, or even through a big city, sometimes they have many train stations, so you need enough time to go from one station to another. So be careful with that. Où est la gare? Where is the train station? Où est la gare? Where is the train station? Where is the train station? This is not a sentence to survive at the station. Because you're not in the station, you're looking for it. Ask your local policeman. Train stations are usually indicated, so they should be easy to find. But if you don't know, just ask anyone, really. Où est-ce que je peux acheter un billet? Where can I buy a ticket? Où est-ce que je peux acheter un billet? Where can I buy a ticket? If you're going abroad from France, sometimes you will have to queue at the ticket counter to get your ticket. Usually people speak English. Où sont les distributeurs automatiques de billets? Where are the ticket machines? Où sont les distributeurs automatiques de billets? Where are the ticket machines? In the station, duh. They are a bit everywhere. Est-ce que ce bus va à? Does this bus go to? Est-ce que ce bus va à? Does this bus go to? Place? You can ask this to the driver of the bus. Because sometimes, again, the map for all the bus routes can be pretty tricky to understand, and you cannot really be sure if you are on the right side of the road to take the right bus in the right direction. So you should ask your bus driver if you're not sure. Où est l'arrêt de bus? Where is the bus stop? Où est l'arrêt de bus? Where is the bus stop? Depending on the city, you will have many bus lines, so you want to find the right bus stop for the right bus line. So if you find a bus stop, it may not be your right line, so be sure to check that too. Le train a du retard. The train's running late. Le train a du retard. The train is running late. It is indeed. Mostly buses are late in France. Trains are okay-ish. They can depart on time. Don't expect them to be really precise. But still be on time just in case it leaves on time this one time. That was a lot of time. Timey time. So have you ever taken a bus or a train in France? And how was it? And was it on time? Tell me in the comments. Usually mine weren't really on time. And if you want to learn more French word about transportation or travel, you can check the website and don't forget to subscribe for more French words. See you next time. Have a good ride and good luck with it. Boop. That's my train pose.
It's getting hot in here.
Welcome back to French Weekly Words. This week's theme is crossing borders. I like crossing borders. Traverser les frontières first. Douane, customs.
You don't like them customs.
To enter a country, you need to go through customs. Pour entrer dans un pays, vous devez passer par la douane.
Ah, how do you say?
Don't bring anything the custom could take away from you. N'emportez rien avec vous que la douane pourrait vous prendre. Next, formulaire de déclaration. Declaration form. Please fill the declaration form. S'il vous plaît, remplissez le formulaire de déclaration. You fill the declaration form, give it to the customs, enter the country. Remplir le formulaire de déclaration, le donner à la douane et rentrer dans le pays. Next. Nationalité. Nationality.
Nationality.
What's your nationality? Quelle est votre nationalité? My nationality is French. Ma nationalité est française. So you just replace French with your own nationality. Next. Passeport. Passport. Almost the same, so easy. I like having many stamps in my passport. J'aime avoir plein de tampons dans mon passeport. So when you enter in France, you give your passport, you get a fancy stamp, and you can show it to everyone after this. Next, visa, which in French is visa. What? Postuler pour un visa, to apply for a visa. Or getting a visa is complicated. Avoir un visa, c'est compliqué. So much paperwork and patience. Next is the end. So once you've crossed your border and go to custom and get your visa and went to quarantine, you're free to enter the country and welcome to lovely France. So enjoy your stay. I'll see you next week. Bye.